YouTube universe. I hope everyone's doing great and having a great beginning of summer. Hope you've been well, and I hope you've been in good health. Thank you to all the new subscribers who've been subscribing to the channel. I appreciate you guys. And this is going to be a video for Jgyokohama. I'm fairly new to his channel, but he's having a contest. And if you're not aware of his channel, go ahead and check him out. Such a positive guy and shows really great albums. He's having a contest, which is ending pretty soon. And I thought this was a really great contest with some really great and unique questions. So the first question he asked was, show an album with an aquatic animal or a manta ray. And I tried to look in my collection. I couldn't find any songs or any records with a manta ray on them. But I did remember I had this album. This is Asia's debut album. And you have the leviathan on there. The beautiful ocean in the background. Another one that came to mind was this record called Deep Voices. Let's see if you can get that there. Deep Voices. It has, you know, the voices of the humpback whales. I believe there was one record released in 1970, which sold like more than 100,000 copies. And soon after, they released this album, which is basically recordings of whales and their songs and just their conversations. So this is the Deep Voices, the second whale album. Another question that he asked was to show an artist or musician, a favorite artist or musician from the Washington DC area. And I have an artist that is a DJ for this group called the Dilated Peoples, which is a hip hop group from here in California and LA. But the DJ from the group, DJ Babu, he was born in Washington, DC. I believe this is the only thing I have on record from them. Everything else I have from them is on CD. But this is one of their hit singles. This is The Platform. And such great stuff that they have released. And I'll put some cuts in here from DJ Babu for you to enjoy. The next question is to show a favorite Japanese artist. And I want to show a few things because I love Japanese culture. And actually, one of my dreams is to be able to visit Japan and to kind of delve in the culture there. Other inspirations that came from wanting to dive into the Japanese culture, and a person who had a really big influence on me on that is this person, Toyohiko Kagawa. And he was pretty much a revolutionary, and he was an activist in Japan. And he was also a type of missionary that kind of spread the gospel in an unusual but powerful way in Japan. So he's mostly called the apostle of love and social justice. This is kind of like an autobiography that I was gifted by a friend. When I was in college, I was diving into Japanese culture, and I ran across Kagawa's work and the stuff that he had done in Japan, and also the poetry that he had done was very powerful. So I quickly fell in love with his work, and quickly fell in love also with the culture and anything related to Japan. And I'm gonna show a couple of artists. This first artist I was actually introduced by my father, and this is Kitaro. This is actually my favorite album from him. This is the third album from the Silk Road trilogy. So this is the third part, I believe, in the series. And I believe for me, this is probably the best one out of the three. It's just a beautiful, beautiful album from start to finish. I love Kitaro's work and the textures, the creativity, and the nature qualities that is very prominent in his work. So if you're not familiar with Kitaro, definitely I recommend you check him out. Jgyokohama, I believe you're familiar, but anybody else who's not familiar with Kitaro, check him out. And another Japanese artist, it's one of my favorite artists, actually one of my favorite guitarists, is Tepe from the band Thrice. This is a band from Orange County, California. And Tepe plays keyboards and lead guitar in the band Thrice. They've been playing together since 1998. And they're one of my favorite bands of all time. And definitely his guitar work is phenomenal. And every record they've produced has been very well thought out and very well composed. This is the album Beggars. I believe this came out. This is a reissue from 2019. So this must have been out in 2009, since this is the 10th anniversary edition. So 2009 is when Beggars came out. And what a great album. This is one of my recent pickups. Has been on my want list for a very long time. And this was actually the only album that I was missing in CD format from the band. I would recommend the song In Exile from this album, if you're not familiar with them at all. That song's a little bit different than their traditional music, but it's a really phenomenal song. So Tepe, great musician from Orange County, from Japanese descent, and he also is into leather goods. He's been he created his own studio, Teranishi, I believe that's his last name, studios, where he is involved in just creating and designing leather goods. And he does all the work on his own, and it's phenomenal just to be able to work from home and also not only have a music creative outlet, but also another creative outlet as creating your own and designing in your own business. So definitely check out Thrice if you're not familiar with them. And he also wanted us to show an album related to Hawaii. And I'm gonna show this album. This is Sunday in Hawaii. If you're not familiar with my channel, I am a gospel collector. I'm in the process of writing a book where I dive into just researching gospel roots and the evolution of gospel music and church music. And this is an album that I came across last year, Sunday in Hawaii. It's off the MCA Records. I believe this album's from 1959. And it's basically church choir music from the island of Kauaiahao. I'm not sure if that's the correct way to pronounce that. But definitely this was a great find to find something like this from MCA Records. Sunday in Hawaii, the Reverend Abraham Hina Akaka. I'll try to put a snippet of this to kind of give you a sense of what it sounds like, but it's church choir music with gospel music. Check out Jgyokohama's channel if you're not familiar. Hope everyone's doing great during these times that we are living in. I hope you are in peace with yourself and in peace with others. God bless you, and I'll see you on the next one. Hopefully doing a couple of more contest entries for some good friends. God bless you guys, and I'll see you on the next one.